Good morning, Transfiguration. I guess we have a lot of late sleepers. Our theme for this week is to serve or be served. Jesus is very clear about how we must act to follow him. Next week, we will celebrate Priesthood Sunday. It is a great opportunity to thank and honor our priests for their ministry. We have gift baskets in the foyer if you'd like to drop a card or a small token of appreciation. There are some ideas on our website. Now, let us stand, share our prayers and needs with those around us.
And now please join us in singing as we begin our celebration.
You are mine. You are worthy. You are worthy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us pause to acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, all your work is done in faithfulness.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, all the earth is full of your love.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we wait for you, our help, our shield.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord was pleased to crush him in infirmity. If he gives his life as an offering for sin, he shall see his descendants in a long life, and the will of the Lord shall be accomplished through him. Because of his affliction, he shall see the light in fullness of days. Through his suffering, my servant shall justify many, and their guilt he shall bear. The word of the Lord.
let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. Of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
Reading from the letter to Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast to our confession, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly and tested in every way, yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of grace to receive mercy and to find grace for timely help. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, We want you to do for us whatever we ask of you. He replied, What do you wish me to do for you? They answered him, Grant that in your glory we may sit one at your right and the other at your left. Jesus said to them, You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the cup that I drink or be baptized with the baptism with which I am baptized? They said to him, We can. Jesus said to them, The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right or at my left is not mine to give, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared. When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at James and John. Jesus summoned them and said to them, You know that those who are recognized as rulers over the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as ransom for many. The Gospel of the Lord. You see those two guys there in the corner? In the stained glass. James and John to the right. And those two guys, they dare tell Jesus today that they want to occupy a position of honor next to him. Oh, well, you know what Jesus told them? You don't know what you're asking for. You don't know what you're asking for. I would say they have really not understood nothing of Jesus' project. Jesus' project of the service of the kingdom and his justice. They're not thinking about following Jesus, but they're thinking about sitting in a good position, one to the right and the other to the left. And Jesus' teaching is clear, my brothers and sisters. That hierarchy of power should not exist among Jesus' followers. Nobody is above others. There are no masters or owners. The parish is not of the priests. And the church does not belong to the bishops and cardinals. Jesus is very clear. Whoever wants to be great, let him start serving everyone. Let him or her start serving everyone. And our true model is Jesus himself. Jesus is not imposing anything. He's not governing anything. He's not controlling. Jesus does not desire any power. And remember, he doesn't like titles. We talked about that about 6 months ago. Remember, no titles, not seeking his own interests. The teaching is clear. His disciples are to serve and to give one's life. To serve and to give our lives, that would make us the first and the greatest. And dear brothers and sisters, we need in the church Christians are willing to spend their lives for the project of Jesus and not for self-interest. We need believers without personal ambitions, believers who work quietly for a more human world up there. Believers who make this church more gospel-like. We need followers of Jesus who impose themselves by their quality of life and service. Service. Up there. Yes, serving at church liturgical ministries, it's nice, but it's not enough. Thank you, Mr. Bill, for being a lector, but that's not enough. Thank you for being an altar server and staying awake. But that's not enough. When you go to school tomorrow, you got to be Jesus' face and Jesus' hands to everyone you meet. Thank you, Ms. Alaro. You work a lot in serving as captain of this mass. But if you think that's enough, bam! No, it's not enough. What we do here is just the beginning. If you're not doing anything else, we're in trouble. If this is all I did, I'm in trouble. This is just the beginning. We need parents who go out of their way for their children, love them, no matter what. Love them as they are. After all, they are your children. We need educators dedicated day after day to the difficult task of teaching and forming our children with love. My dear brothers and sisters, we need men and women who have made their lives out there a service to those in need. Remember the exit sign? As we go out there to serve those in need. Those are the best we have in the church. The ones who serve out there. Those are the greatest in the eyes of Jesus. May God bless you. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring our prayers before the Lord, who is our help and our shield.
For the Pope, bishops, and priests, that they continue to be faithful servants of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the world leaders will work for the common God, for the common good of all those entrusted to them. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those preparing to vote in the upcoming election, help us to follow in the footsteps of Jesus and his apostles, who continue to guide us to your kingdom of justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who work in service of others, particularly Family Promise, who help the homeless, may they continue their assistance joyfully. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us gathered here, may God strengthen us against temptation and graciously hear our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord. For the sick, especially Father Fernando and those brothers and sisters in our parish, may God's loving care for them bring them consolation and healing. Let us pray to the Lord. For the repose of the soul of Bob Ingalls, from whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord. That all who have died will share in eternal life with Christ, especially Kathy Harrigan, Luz Yolanda Cole, and Timothy Giles. Let us pray to the Lord. That we all take a moment of silence to pray for our intentions and the intentions of the people around us.
Loving Father, your Son Jesus came not to be served, but to serve. Hear our prayers and help us to serve all in need. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies, a faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. To be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth the Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Señor mío y Dios mío, eres mi Dios y eres mi Señor. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Señor mío, Dios mío, tú eres mi Dios y eres mi Señor. A mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed unto us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Bishop, the auxiliary bishops, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own, open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor on our burden. Make us serve them truly after the example of Jesus Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember Bob Ingalls and our brothers and sisters who are falling asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. During communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray to the Father in the words Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. And by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. To go out through those exit doors and serve everyone you meet. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Those taking the Eucharist are brothers and sisters. Please take Jesus to them and pray with them. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepare for gifts that are eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. St. Vincent de Paul Clothing Drive will be Saturday, October 26th, Sunday, October 27th. As you go out, you're going to see various tables in the narthex. The men's club has tickets. Also sign up for the blood drive. Women Helping Others has information and tickets. And there is a Homebound Friends information. This is the beginning. It's not enough. There's a lot to do out there. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good Sunday.